Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Bully. Today, I am going to show you guys how to create a print-on-demand store using Printify, WordPress, and WooCommerce to help you create an online store without having physical products and equipment. Before we get started, I want to welcome back my subscribers. I appreciate all of you. But for those who are brand new to the channel, my name is Bully. I create tutorials and talk about web designs focusing on user experience using WordPress and WooCommerce. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet and turn on that bell notification so you won't miss any future uploads about web designs from me. If you guys find this video helpful somehow, please give it a thumbs up to help support the channel. I would appreciate your support a lot. Thank you. There are also some other best ways to help support my channel that I encourage you guys to visit my website to check out on my merch and web consulting services. I have a 20% off coupon for you guys to use with free shipping. If you guys don't want to support my channel that way, you can also join my Patreon or donate to my channel directly. I would appreciate your support and help a lot. Thank you so much. By the way, I have a private group to discuss e-commerce web designs on Discord. Join our private community if you like. It's always free to join. I add all the links in the description box below for you guys to check out. Without further ado, let's jump right in. Let's open the Printify website. Go to printify.com. If you haven't have an account with them, you need to sign up. If you do, just click the login button. In this case, I already have an account with them for my web design merch. Once you get into your dashboard, just click the My Store link on the top. This is one of my current stores. And when you go to my files, you could upload some of the PNG files over there and then add all the payments right here. This tab is for indirect taxes. If you live in the US or your store is based on the US, you need to submit this tax form because they started since in October 2020. And then just click on that link and click the fill out the form and click the submit button. Let's check on the My Stores tab. This one is for the list of all the stores that you have. The settings tab, just change the time where your store is located. The connections tab is for the API tokens and the contact email. And as for my account tab, it's just the business name. Let's add a new store here. We will connect to my demo store. Click that button, scroll down and select connect to WooCommerce. Type in your store URL in the box. Make sure to log into your online store as an admin before you click the connect button. Copy your URL and paste it right there. Click the approve button. Make sure it is your email address right here. And then you will be redirected back to the printify.com. Click on the drop-down arrow on the top right to select your store. The default name that Printify gave to you is WooCommerce Store, so we will change the name of the store. Click Manage My Stores, and then click the gear icon to the right of your store name to change the name of your store. And right here, just type whatever you want to name your store right here. Scroll down a little bit to click the save button. And let's go back to the demo store. Or just click the My Store on the top. Right now, our store is empty. We need to add a product. Click the Add Product button on the top right. And then it will let you search and pick a product from here. Scroll down a little bit to see what they have. I am going to select the women's clothing. Let's check out the hoodies. I will select the unisex heavy blend hoodie right here. And before you can upload your file, your graphic, you need to pick a print provider first. You can scroll down to see more information and make sure to compare the pricing right here for each provider and how much they're gonna charge for the shipping and how many days it's gonna be done for the production time. And you need to pay attention to the rating also. As long as it's above 9.1, it should be good. That one is $17.85, but the shipping is $9.40. Let's scroll down a little bit. Let's see what they have. Let's see, this one's Swift Pod. The rating is 9.6 and it's $15.22. The shipping is about $9. And the average production time is about 3 business days. But other stores have different prices and more expensive. It looks like this store has a good rating and decent prices so far. Let's choose the SwiftPod store. Right here we have to upload our demographic. You could use the button add design right here. If you have your design store on your computer, you just select my device right there. Or Dropbox or wherever you have your file at. That's the requirements on the bottom right there. That's the size, recommended size for the hoodie. I will use my existing files. In this case, I already have my files in my library. For this tutorial, let's select this one. And right now it is white color. And I will pick out a couple colors and deselect the white because my desire is for dark color clothing. I will pick only a couple of colors in this case. Let's go with the black, blue, and pink. That looks good. Yeah, you could drag the graphic within the dotted line of that square or rectangle box. Once everything looks good, just click the Save Product button at the bottom. And before we click the Publish button, we need to edit the listing first. Click the Edit Listing button. Use any colors of your selection right here as a default product that your customers will see. And right here, that's the title. Now here in this box is for the description. Don't forget to add the size table to the description also. That is a very helpful information that your customers may need for a better user experience. Below here is for pricing. Printify gives you about 40% for the profit margin. So just click the arrow button to expand each size. And then you just click the profit right there. Click the price to modify the price, whatever you want. And then it will recalculate everything for you automatically. Let's change the price right here for an example. So the next box for the profit margin, it changed to 46% for you. Once everything looks good, scroll down a little bit more and we will click the publishing option right there to publish your product to your WooCommerce store. Once everything looks good, click the publish button at the bottom. It should take less than a minute or a couple minutes here for Printify to publish a product to your store. It's done. We need to enable the automated routing right here. This is for when your customer buys an available product, it will select another provider to get that product for your customers, but it will charge you about $2 extra right here. But it is good to enable this feature. You don't want to tell your customers that, oh, we don't have this product available for you. You need to order something else or something like that would not be a good idea. And let's go back to our main dashboard right here. It looks good. Let's go to the front end. Yep, it's right here now. It shows. Let's go to its page. Right here, we need to edit the product page to add a little bit of information for this page. So far, Printify pushed or added this product to your store automatically on their end. We need to add a short description. So let's go back to the dashboard and go to products and all products. That's our hoodie. Let's click on it so we can edit it. Right here. We need to assign a new category for this hoodie. Just let's go with hoodie for now, just for an example. Yep, that looks good. Scroll down a little bit. If you want to change all the description, it's up to you. It's up there. And if you have an SEO plugin installed, you need to add a meta description in this box so people can find this product on the internet when they search for a certain hoodie. That will help you out a lot to help people to find your product. Scroll down a little bit more here. Let's check the variations. These are all the sizes that Printify added to the demo store. If you need to change the prices, you need to change them in your Printify account in your store. When you are done changing them, just publish them back to your print-on-demand store to be updated automatically. Let's add a little bit of the product short description right here. This information will be displayed on top of the page. it will be displayed underneath its title or its product name. Once everything looks good, just click the update button. Let's go back to the front end and refresh the page to see all the changes that we just made. Oh, right there. You see the short description that we just added? It's right there right now. And let's do some testing real quick. It looks good so far. And then once everything looks good, you can just click the add to cart button. And that's pretty much it. That's all for today's tutorial. Leave me a comment below what you guys think about owning a print-on-demand store using Printify. I would love to hear from you guys a lot. Again, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on that bell notification so you won't miss any future uploads about web designs from me. And if you guys find this video helpful somehow, please give it a thumbs up. That would help out my channel a lot. Thank you so much for your support. I always appreciate it. Thanks again for being here to watch my video. I always appreciate it. All right, I wish you guys have a wonderful day wherever you are. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye now.